Hello and welcome to the Spatial Structures Movers and Shakers interview series as we look ahead to the ISS Annual Symposium and Spatial Structures Conference taking place at the University of Surrey in August 2021. My name is Mark Richardson and today I'm joined by Peter Novosedlak, who's a structural and project engineer at TIO Europe. Peter, thanks very much for taking the time to speak to us today.
Yeah, thank you for the invitation.
No problem. It's great to have you on the series. So we start by asking our guests a little bit about the lockdown period. How has that been for you in Germany?
Well, for me personally, it was quite a difficult time, especially the home office period, because already the very small and everyday tasks become much more complex when you are alone or isolated from the other colleagues or simply from the office environment. But luckily, the things are getting better now. We are back in the office and we are hoping all for the best.
Yes, thank you. And that answer definitely resonates with some of the experiences we've had here in the UK. Maybe you could tell us a bit about your career journey to date. That's something we're exploring in the series. It'd be great to hear about your career.
Well, my professional background is in structural engineering. And after I finished my master's studies, I have continued with theory of structures on a PhD level, where I focused mostly on the numerical techniques for design, analysis, and structural optimization of the structures, spatial structures, and mostly with the focus on tensile membrane structures. After PhD and after several years of engineering practice, I have joined an institute for shell and membrane structures in Dessau in Germany to continue my education already as a professional. And there I got an offer to join TIO Europe as a structural engineer. I accepted this offer and since 2018, I am working almost exclusively in the field of the tensile structures.
Great, thanks for that, Peter. You alluded to the fact there that you work for TIO Europe, which is the European arm of TIO Corgio Corporation, excuse me. And this organization has had a long and productive working relationship with the University of Surrey Spatial Structures Research Center. Maybe you could tell us a bit more about your organization.
Well, TIO Corgio is based in Japan and it was established in 1922. So it's almost 100 years old company. In recent times, it has more than 2,000 employees and has branches all over the world. In Europe, we are TIO Europe, in Australia, China, United States, and also many other offices, smaller offices all around the world in many other countries. On a global level, TIO Corgio is running several fabrication facilities, which are fabricating not only tensile structures, but also special steel structures. It runs own material testing laboratory, which is quite unique in the field, and invests a lot of effort and money in development of the fabrication tools. It has its own IT department, which is developing and maintaining the softwares, which we are normally using. And the software is dealing with design of tensile structures with productions and with production control. So TIO Corgio on the global level is active in the whole field of membrane technology.
That's great. Thank you, Peter. And maybe you could tell us about some of the standout spatial structures that TIO Corgio Corporation or TIO Europe has led and helped deliver.
So TIO Corgio itself, during the almost 100 years of existence, had a chance to cooperate or participate on several projects that are currently landmarks in tensile structures. Like, for example, the Millennium Dome in London was done by TIO, or Sony Center in Berlin, for example, Tokyo Dome, huge structure, or famous convertible umbrellas for Medina. This is from the history, very famous project. But TIO Europe actually is active in most or in many projects on almost every sports events, like, for example, Football World Cups, Olympic Games, and also has designed and delivered many structures for expo exhibitions, which is currently postponed because of the situation to the next year. We are present also there.
Well, thanks for that overview, Peter. That was interesting. And the Nomura Foundation, which belongs to the Taiyo Kogyo Corporation, has sponsored the 2021 ISS conference. Maybe you can tell us a bit more about this particular foundation and some of its objectives.
Yeah, membrane structures has a wide field and wide variety of applications in the world, not only for the civil engineering structures like we normally know them, but membrane technologies have applications also in aerospace industries, in offshore engineering, in underwater and underground for ground stabilization engineering. So the potential of membrane structures is huge. Taiyo, as a global player, recognizes this potential, and through the Nomura Foundation, they're trying to support the research and development of the membrane technology and also support the international exchange of the knowledge to deliver a better future.
Perfect. Thanks for that, Peter. So we now move to the middle section of the presentation, which is entitled Your Space, Your Structure. So I'm going to hand over presenting rights to Peter, who's going to take us through a short presentation on some structures that have either inspired him or you've worked on directly. So over to you, Peter.
So thanks for the word. And today I would like to talk about an EPFE, a material that is very popular in the recent structures in the world of tensile engineering. EPFE is more or less a plastic material, which is very lightweight. For architectural applications, it comes within the thickness of less than half a millimeter. It's UV stable and very resistant to weathering, aging, and many chemicals. And very good news about this material is that it's 100% recyclable. From structural point of view, the material is very light because it's thin, and it delivers tensile strength that is good enough for structural applications. But besides its lightweight, the most impressive advantage that ETFE as a material has that it's flexibility. It means that ETFE can be used in the projects that are completely flat or they are curved, as you see on the picture, to negative Gaussian curvature. These shapes we usually know from the typical fabric structures, but also ETFE can adapt these shapes. But most important and most often is the appearance of the positive Gaussian curvature shapes, which are natural for inflated structures. ETFE, because it's transparent and very flexible, it's very suitable for, especially for inflated cushions applications. From the projects that we have recently realized, the simplest way how to use the ETFE is in the form of flat transparent structure. This transportation project in Brussels is cable supported single layer ETFE, and the purpose of the ETFE there is not only cladding but also load bearing. It's single layer, but below the structure, an additional layer of PVC triangles is added to make the architectural appearance more maybe nice and to deliver also some shading. But ETFE itself doesn't have to be only transparent and clear, as you see on the picture, but can be also printed, as shown for this transportation project in Poland. And the possibilities of printing are limited just by the fantasy of the designer. So in this single-layer ETFE structure for the foil fulfills not only the load-bearing and cladding function, but also an architectural street art. Projects from ETFE in a smaller scale, besides it's printed, can include also some technology. When you will have a look more detailed on this picture, the little brown islands in the facade are not the printing, but actually integrated PV panels. So this facade structure includes also the production of electricity, and all these functions are connected in the film that is 0.25 millimeter thick. From the curved projects, I think this is a very outstanding example. It's a US embassy in London, and it's a single layer ETFE, which is stretched over the steel structure and it's stabilized with an edge cables. The function is purely aesthetic and architectural, but as you can see, the curvature of the system and the complexity of the whole facade is dominating the whole architectural impression of the building. The most usual application of ETFE is in inflated, multi-layer inflated structures that we are normally calling cushions. As you can see, these cushions can be mass produced in a certain shape, or you can deliver a structures where you cannot find two cushions that are similar or have a similar geometry. Good news is that with increasing complexity of the final shape, the complexity of the production and fabrication of the ETFE structures it's not increased or increased only a little. From this point of view, the very specially curved and architecturally pleasing structure is, from the financial point of view, competitive to very flat and simple structures. So one of my favorite projects is this commercial project in St. Petersburg, Russia. And on this project, it can be proved that cushions are not very soft and flexible structures like they look, but they are able to withstand very drastic, I would say, the winter climate that Russia is famous for. Also, it's able to withstand the high loads of the snow, for example, the very low temperatures in the winter, and also high wind loads, because this structure is exposed to the sea or to the lake, and every structural engineer knows that in such an exposition the wind loads are very high. And by this structure, it can be proven that ETFE is a reliable construction also for very demanding environments, like is the case of this project. ETFE cushions are very often delivered in multi-layer or multi-chamber constructions, where the inner layers can be used for various purposes, while the top and bottom layers are used mostly to carry the loads. The inner layer can, for example, be printed to deliver shades, or in case of this construction in Munich, it's used to support the photovoltaic panels and generate the electricity. Besides generating electricity, the large density of the panels offer also some shading. And last example that I have for this presentation is this facade, which is maybe on the first sight not very interesting structure, but with inclusion of artificial lighting, it becomes interesting after the sunset. And it can be, as well as printed ETFE, it can be interesting in many different ways. And the final architectural impression is limited only by the fantasy of the designer. So I hope you like this small excursion to the world of ETFE and current work of Taiyo Kogyo.
Peter, thanks very much for taking us through that presentation. That was a joy to watch. Maybe just a quick follow-up question on the presentation. In terms of ETFE fabrication times, how would that compare to other similar materials which might be applied? Maybe you could talk us through the fabrication times for ETFE.
Well, it's comparable to all other fabric structures. And I would say that it's even shorter.
Great. Well, that's good to know. And, you know, as I said, wonderful to see the various applications of ETFE across a range of applications. So, fascinating. Thank you very much for that, Peter. Moving to the final section of our presentation then, we're looking obviously at ISS 2021, which this series is here in part to promote. A key theme of ISS 2021 is about inspiring the next generation. And I wonder, Peter, how do you think this aim can be best achieved in the field of spatial structures?
Well, I would say that the professionals of current times, current professionals, should do design and build the structures as best as they can. They should design the structures that are worth to take a picture of them. I remember I was inspired just by watching the pictures of famous buildings, and it made me want to join this field. So according to my own experience, I think that we current professionals should just do the work as best as we can. This will deliver surely the motivated generation.
Okay, great advice. Like that, Peter. And from your perspective, maybe you can tell us about the importance of private industry working in conjunction with academia in the development of spatial structures. We've also already talked about how the University of Surrey has collaborated with Taiyo, and maybe you could talk about the importance of these two sort of worlds, if you like, coming together to help shape spatial structures in the future.
Yeah, exactly. The main purpose of one of the main goals of academia and university in general is to search for innovations and to deliver exact or at least optimal solutions to existing problems. On the other hand, engineering and industry is living or earning its living from application of the latest knowledge to the real life. So I think that the more tight the connection of industry and academia will be, the more efficient and innovative structure we can see in the future.
That's great, Peter, and definitely something to aspire to. We like innovative structures, so something to think about. It's been a real pleasure talking to you today, Peter, on the Movers and Shakers interview series. Fantastic opportunity to learn about your own background, but also Taiyo Kogyo's work and applications and the numerous examples you were kind enough to share us in the presentation. So thank you very much for your time, and hopefully we can catch up with you again on the 15-minute meet series as we move closer to the ISS 2021 conference. But for now, thank you very much.
Thank you for the invitation.